Hello and welcome, myself Rehan Ali, and today in this video we are gonna write our code for printing these reversed pyramid patterns such as solid pyramid, hollow pyramid, hollow pyramid with cross. And so without any further ado, let's get started. Here in this pattern also we'll use two inner loops as like this. First loop is responsible for printing white spaces, and second inner loop is used for printing our pattern symbols or stars. So for printing these spaces, we need to run our first inner loop from 0 to 6, means for first row there is no any space printed. For the second row we print one space there, and similarly for the third row we are printing two white spaces there, and so on. As there is number of rows are 7, our outer loop will run 7 times as like this. Row value is varying from 1 to 7, like for first row, row value is 1, and for the second row, it is 2, and for the third row, row value is nothing but 3, and so on. So we can use our condition as like this. Means for row value 1, this loop will not run because call value is 1 here, and 1 is not smaller than 1. And this is the behavior that we also want here. Now for row value 2, this loop will run one time as 1 is smaller than 2. And similarly for row value 3, this loop will run 2 times, and so on. Means our first inner loop for printing white spaces will look something like this. If you are unfamiliar with the working of the for loop, you can watch my first video of this series in which I have explained how the for loop actually works. You can find the link of that video above in iCard button here, or you can also find the same link in the description of this video. So now let's drive some condition for our second inner loop to print these pattern symbols here. Here for first row, call value is 13, means 2 times values of the numbers minus 1, and for the second row this value is 11, similarly for the third row this value is 9, and so on. If we carefully analyze these values, for each value of row, call value is decremented by 2 each time. For example, for first row it is 13, but for the second row this value is 11, and also for the third row this value is 9, and so on. So for simplicity we'll use one extra temp variable here and assign it this first value of row, here it is 13, in this way. And now decrement this value by 1 for each row. We can write temp equals to temp minus 2, or we can use this shorthand notation here. That's it. Now this loop will print stars as we needed here. Let's give it a try. Here, as we discussed, I declared this temp variable here with the value of 13 in this case after evaluating this equation. And this is the loop that we made for printing spaces here. And this loop is used for printing stars here. We are running this loop number of times defined by the temp value. So for the first row, this value is 13. Then we decrement it by 2. So for the second time, it is 11, and so on. Let's run it to see the output. Here it is, we get our reverse pyramid printed here. Now let's see our second pattern. Here this pattern is like this one, but here we just need to print stars in these parts only, and for rest of the values we print white spaces. So for this purpose we can use one if else block here in this way. Here when some conditions are true, print stars or these pattern symbols, otherwise print white spaces. So for printing this part here, we know that each time this loop is starting from 1. See this part. So we can drive our first condition as like this. Means print starts when call value is nothing but the 1. Similarly, we are ending with this temp value here, and this temp value is nothing but these values such as 13, 11, 9 and 7 and so on. So our second condition will look something like this here. Now we need to print this part here. So this part is nothing but our first row, as you can see here. So our last condition will look something like this. So we need to print stars only for these particular values, other than these values print the white spaces. That is why we have used this if else block here. This if else block will contain these conditions. That's it. Let's write our code for this pattern. Here this is the code that we written for printing solid pyramid. Now we'll replace this part with the conditions that we derived earlier as like this. Now let's run it. And yeah, this is nothing but our hollow reversed pyramid. Now let's see our next pattern. Here, as we can see, this pattern is very similar to this pattern, only this extra part is printed here, means all the conditions of the hollow pyramid is also valid for this pattern. Now let's drive some more conditions to print this extra part here. Here, if we see this value is nothing but half of the tempo value. But as C language returns a rounded integer value, this value will be like these 6, 5, and 4. But here, our requirement is to print stars in these places. So we can simply add 1 to these values to get our task done. So we can say this is nothing but our first extra condition. Now this part is also similar. Instead of considering column values as before, these values are rows here. So this is also approximately half of the numbers. We can use this condition for printing this part here. And yeah, these are all the conditions to print this specific pattern. Let's give it a try. Here in this code, we have to add these two more conditions. I'll use one else if block here to make it more readable. Just run it and see the output. Congratulations, we did it. We successfully wrote our code to print these patterns. Thanks for the patience. If you like this tutorial, please click on the like button and share it with your friends. Also subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to never miss out any incoming videos like this one. And that being said, see you in the next video.